spring's coming.
All right, good morning, everybody. I am walking in off the side and getting ready to get started. So here we are, it's Thursday. We are going to take ourselves through a cardio and strength workout. I am Linda, very excited to have you here. Couple of things. If you have a bench, even with risers, maybe one set under each end available to you, please feel free to grab that. If you don't have it, everything that we do, you can do on the floor. I have a set of moderate to moderately heavy weights off to the side, so we're going to do some cardio, we're going to do some strength. We'll add in a little bit of core and warm ourselves up. This studio is a little chilly, so I'm very excited to be starting. I'm going to go over to my music and maybe take a couple of shoulder rolls and get all ready to go and relaxed. All right. So we hear the music coming in. Let's take a moment and roll those shoulders all the way around. Open and release. Ah, good. Let's reverse that. That reverses all those hunched shoulders we have in this weather. Should we reach up? Let's do a little tap. Holding our hands here. We don't involve the arms too much. Let's take the legs a little lower. Good. Perfect. Release and go long. Now I've got a nice flat hand, wide open. Let's change it. Push. Here's our little punch. We have two more. Go high and low. Each time we reach, maybe it gets a little bigger. Low and high. Four more, two more, getting there. Touch step in. Hold those arms open for a second. Take it wide for a second. Let's make a goal post. Pull it in. Ready? Push. Let's push those arms forward, shall we? Get that big reach. So I hope we're feeling a little warmer. Let's ham curl. Those arms come right by our sides. I have those flat palms again. Good. We have four, three, two. Make your fists pull, pull. Watch where I'm going. Here we go. It's a nice big move. Two more. Come back to the middle. Cross those arms. And of course, we're going to end up going that way. Shall we? Let's do four, three, two, march it out. Take a deep breath in, inhale, and release. Little march. Deep breath in. Step forward and back. Now, I am, of course, making sure I don't overextend my space. End up hitting the wall. You use as much space as you'd like. Remember, you can do this on the step, on the floor so easily. How about two more? We're gonna run it up. Now, I don't have any risers. I normally use them, but I think this works just fine. Just give a walk forward and back. Run it up. How about two more? Last time. Walk it forward and back. Run it up. Let's close this out. Yeah. Give me that little run. Corner curl. Now, if I were on the floor, I would look like this. And believe me, we're all gonna be on the floor on occasion today. Give me that curl again. Let's try it. Two more. Now everyone, curl it on your floor. It's moving side to side. Good. Curl it on the bench, ham curl. Two more. Cha-cha push on the floor. We're gonna fly today. Let's curl it again. Two more. Curl it on the floor, all of us. Back onto your bench. Cha-cha push. Very nice. Now, curl it. Repeat that curl. Curl it. We're on the other side. Curl it on the floor. Back onto your bench. Two more. Cha-cha push. Push it. Curl it on your bench. Nice. On the floor. So if we're on the floor, it's a pretty big turn, isn't it? Back to your bench. Let's do a big cha-cha push. Push those arms. Two more. Single corner curl. Repeater. Watch this change. Cha-cha push two times. That's two full times. Curl it. Repeat it. Put. Cha-cha push. Two more. Curl it. Repeat it. Let's do that again. Cha-cha push. Here's that curl. Let's open the arms. And repeat it. Cha-cha push. Let's open our arms and curl. Repeat it. Let's change some things. Quarter knee. Repeat that knee. Single knee. Repeat it. Do it again. So we have a big quarter knee, and then we repeat it. If we were on the floor, corner knee, we would look like this. Repeat that knee. Knee, kick, knee. Other side. Let's do it again. How about one more? I'd like a nice corner tap. Now tap it, take that foot behind. Got two more. Excellent. Corner knee. Repeat that knee. You can make it as dynamic as you like. Single knee, we'll show you how. Repeat it. Corner knee. Give me your repeater. You can go low. Single knee. Let's repeat it. Knee, kick knee. Other side. You got two more. Last one. Listen, listen. Cha-cha push. Excellent. Let's back to our curl. Repeat that curl. Cha-cha push. Corner curl. Here's our repeater. Let's do big knees. Maybe we open the arms. Now our repeater, nice and hot, kind of off the end. Single knee. Repeat it. Knee kick knee. And again. We have two more. Last one. Cha-cha push. Let's curl it, get to the other side. Repeat that curl. I want a giant corner knee. Repeat it off the end. Single knee. Repeat it off the end. Knee kick knee. Other side. Your kick is as high as you want it to be. Let's curl it. Repeat your curl. Cha-cha push. Let's stay here. Make this something something. We're gonna drop nice and low. So remember we call this drop the chach. Hop the chach. One, two, up. So we get a little height. Last four. Four, three, two, tap it. We're gonna do just a few more minutes of this, and then come down to the floor and still stay with our cardio. Let's tap outside. Looks like that. Off to the side. We have another four, four, three, two more. Remember, spin cycle, tap in the middle. Pivot around, corner knee, tap in middle. Make a big full pivot. Corner knee, tap it middle. Pivot, corner knee, tap it middle. Pivot, corner knee. Center right and left. So here we are. Let's take that little tiny pattern we built from scratch and just do it one more time. Staying very simple, very uncomplicated. As we move along, we get really good at these things. I'll teach you some of the things that I have named very strange names. Feel free to run it up or just keep stepping back, forward and back. I have the depth step in honor of Pirates of the Caribbean. Spin cycle you already have heard about. And there is the transformer. But now we got stuff to do. Curl it. Repeat it. Single curl. Repeat it. Cha-cha push. It doesn't have to come back exactly the same way. Curl it. Repeat it. Good. We're back to our curl. Open those arms. We know how to repeat it. Make it big and strong. Single curl. Repeat it. Best cha-cha push you can give me. Two more. Let's curl our way out of this. Repeat it. Big corner knee. Repeat off the end. See how those arms can open? Single knee. Repeat off the end. Knee kick knee. Other side. Got two more. Last one. Tap it to your corner. Tap outside. Tap it middle. Pivot. Corner knee. Corner knee. We're back. Repeat off the end. See how that all puts itself together? Single knee. Repeat off the end. Knee kick knee. Other side. How high do you want your kick to go? We all get to choose. One more. Corner tap. Tap outside. Tap it middle. Pivot. quarter knee. March it on the floor. So here we are. I'm going to move this out of the way for a second. We're not going to use it necessarily. I want us to take ourselves into a little bump up. No bench. Now we just have this nice little march. Four more, three, two, watch me. Out, out, jack, jack. Now, is this a real fast tempo? No. We can do it fast, but we don't have to today. So then we make it big. Out, out. Remember, you could do this, always bringing it to a low impact. One, two, up, up. Let's do a few more. Remember your options. Last one. Stay here. Shift, shift. Remember this? We don't have a lot of snow to shovel, do we? Three, two, in, out. Scoop it. So I would like you to take those arms and drag them across. Now make it more of a run for eight. Four, three, two, in, out, other side. We really lean into this. Four, three, two, in, out, scoop it. We are getting some great core work, some great rotation. Four, three, two, in, out for four, three, four, three, two, one. Now let's change this. Should we change this just a little bit? Go like this. So we build a little hesitation. Excellent. Four, three, two, in, out. Let's do it again. Now, push those arms. Last time. Four, three, two, in, out. March it out. So hopefully we've got just a little cardio bump. I'm going to add something in. Now we're going to try and do those three segments together. Two knees, opposite leg back. One, two, back, stand. Now, I think standing a little bit wide is really a good idea. Let's hit it. One, two, back, stand. One, two, back, stand. We can make it as dynamic as we want. Now we've got this rhythm down. I'm going to ask you to do something. One more. I'm going to ask you to go down your own road. Fast as you can, or slow as you can. Whatever you like. So we're going to just make this a little bit more dynamic. We have three more. Two more. One more. Stand. One, two, back. Sometimes it can get a little getting used to be on the other leg, yeah? One, two, bump it up. Thank you. now that we know where we're going. Let's do another four of these, and then we're gonna take our own path. So we're pulling out of the music. One, two. Here we go. One, two. Ready? I'm breathing for everybody. We have another four. I have another three. Two more. Last one. Shake it out. Touch step in. We're going to do a really small segment because we are running out of time. We got other stuff to do. Let's do our little march and then press out and jack. Here we go. Out, out. Up, up. Only another two. That's all we need. Ready? Scoop it. Four, three, two. Squeeze it. Four, three, two. Push it along. With some force. And we know we don't have to jump in, don't we? Good. Two knees. Back, up. One, two. Back, up. Only one more, one more. Change legs. One, two. Back, stay. Ah, nice. It has to be our last one today. But there we go. Shake it out. We have something new, which is very nice. Here's what's going to happen today. I want you to pick up, take a little breath, take a little release if you like. Grab your weights, your heavy to moderately heavy. We are going to be working on long lever extensions, which means that we start by rolling those shoulders back. We are going to dead row, but just on one side. So we squeeze up, squeeze. We have time to really pull that arm up strongly, hitch it to that nice 90 degree angle. Now we have a lateral raise. We're out again. Every time we do this, we should feel that sensation. Let's go to the other side. Of contraction right into the muscle, right into the rhomboids. Let's do our lateral raise. And yes, I am leaning over. If that doesn't feel comfortable, you should stand here. If this doesn't feel comfortable, just bend your elbows. Let's go to the other side. We have four good strong pulls. Two more. Come into that lateral raise. Go out and in. Let's go to the other side. Pull. Pull. Even harder. Lateral raise. So just another different way of approaching. Let's go back to our right side. Two lateral raises. Go to the left side. Big squeeze. Two raises. And here it is, one and one. Up to the side. So. We want to manage this weight. Let's go to the other direction. Big squeeze. What's most important is that we lift up into the move, stand tall, everybody. I want you to take these weights all the way around and press them all the way down. Now, pulling right here. We lift it. We're coming in and out. Standard shoulder press. Chin is tucked. Now, if we had a shoulder issue, we might decide not to use any weight, wouldn't we? So I want a big, strong press. And as you can see, I have one toe tipped back. That is very intentional. Hold here. Sometimes what can happen, we end up standing like this. So if we split that stance, tuck the tailbone, engage the abdominals, we're usually good. Here we go. Up, straight up. So we go in and out, and then up and down. Now, it is my ever reminder that we take breaks when we need them, right? Yes, we do. How about two more? Let's do our last one. Excellent. Tucking that weight in. As you can see today, our focus is actually going to be on upper body more than lower body. So know that that's the case. We are, however, going to ask that upper body, that lower body, to do a little bit of work for us as we drop, fly, stand tall. I have one foot slightly ahead of the other, and we're opening up. It's like we are butterflying ourselves open. What we aren't doing is this. It's a very, think of it as a confined movement. Drop it, open. We are trying to move that work down the back. How about two more? One more. Now holding here. Hold here. Here's that little bit of leg work. We're gonna step forward, back, forward, back. Stay really low. I issued this challenge today. How low can you get? The lower we get, the less we bring our foot forward sometimes. Because this is easy, isn't it? And this isn't too bad. And this is also excellent work. Down here, maybe we bring a little sizzle. Now give me a pulse. We are lightly lodged in that back toe, which is sitting right by our instep. Let's drop it even a little lower. Let's do 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, stand. Other side, other foot comes forward. We're gonna drop and fly. Here we go. Drop, open. It is a hinge of the hips. Coming to that strong fly. Now, to fly is different from a lateral raise. My palms are opening up slightly. Let's do another four. Three more. Here's our two. Last one. And now we drop low, just so those legs don't get forgotten. It's a great time to reconnect with our belly and our core, all through that back. We tap forward. We tap to the instep. We try to get down down kind of low. I love isometric work. And as we're doing this, I'll tell you a story. So years ago, step didn't yet exist. I taught it on the floor and everything else. But then step came into play. And I said, I don't want to learn that. I don't think so. Let's pulse it. And I used to go to classes and feel quite lost. At that time, I wore contacts. So my default, keep pulsing, when I got really lost, was the same thing to go, oh gosh, there's something in my eye again. I can't believe that. Don't understand why that keeps happening. And then, I got better and better. And it is actually a love of mine and has been for years. Stand tall. What that reminds us of is that we can always learn new things. So I don't pretend that I have something in my eye anymore. And I don't wear contacts anymore. So that would be a problem if I did, because people would catch on really fast. We're going to do some long lever extension. Let's pull our bellies in, snug it. I want you to reach opposite arms. We have 4, 3, 2. Now listen, fast and slow. Hold, return. Hold it, return it. How about two more? One more. Now we're gonna pulse it. We go 3, 2, 1, return. 3, 2, and what if you're a little low? What if you're down here? 3, because you can't reach all that way. That's just 5. Let's change sides, reset our bodies, drop it in, and extend. We only have another 4, 3, 2. Now it's quick and slow. Here we go. You want to control it. We don't want to do this, do we? Well, we might want to, but we won't. Big reach. Let's do our little pulse at the top. 3, 2, 1. Release. 3, 2. Remember, if you need to go low, this is excellent work. Stand tall, shake it out. Little changes coming. If you like, just hang on to this one weight. We're gonna reach forward and back with one arm and then small extensions out to the side. It looks like this. I reach forward, I reach really far back. So it is now we're taking that work we did on the diagonal and we're just moving it to one side. We want to control it. Remember where our pocket is? Our pocket is our hip bone. So we don't want to go past the pocket when we are reaching and swinging. Let's change sides. Take it all the way back. As we extend behind us, hopefully that tricep is doing a little bit of the work. Let's take another 4. Two more. It's our last one. Shake it out. I confess, I have a small sniffle. It is very cold in this room when we start, and then it warms up. We're going to just observe a couple interesting things. I want us to extend out to the side. Very small movement, very small. This is what I'm going to change out my weights. Next, you're going to increase my weight a bit because I want to feel that resistance. And this is going to better illustrate something that I know occurs with me. We only lift one arm. Very fine movement. We should feel this running through the front of the arm, back of the shoulders, so that anterior deltoid is the posterior delt. It is a very tiny movement. We have another four, three, two more. Let's change side. We lift. But again, it is a very small, very controlled extension. If your weight is too light, that's okay. Just come up and hesitate a bit. That little hesitation, let's do four, three, two, and one. Now, we reach a little higher. We go small. So here's what I observed, because I did this last night with the 5 o'clock class. One side of my body, as with almost everyone, is a little weaker than the other because it's not my dominant side. I am always facing you. So your right side is actually my left. And that is the arm, in particular doing this, that tired out pretty quickly. Why is this important to know? Let's shake it out. Turning our weights open. We're going to execute some reciprocal curls, but I want us in the middle. We're going to take our weights right across our thighs, roll those shoulders back. We lift. So I'm going back to my question. Why is it important to understand that we have imbalances? Because then we can know two things. First, that it's okay, it's very normal. And second, that we might work one side a bit more. Develop better strength on that side. Four, three, two, one, release. Take those weights behind, flip the palms up, and squeeze. So, we're gonna go a bit rogue. We're not gonna worry about the tempo of the music. We're just lifting. We have these soft, soft elbows. A little bit of a pulse. It's a great way to bring the triceps in real easily. And do you feel this in the upper trapezius and the top, right across the back? Yes, you do. Absolutely. Let's do another four. This is three, two, one. Release. Let's bring those weights up and hold them here. Doesn't look like much is happening, does it? But we don't think about this, that the biceps are involved in shoulder thrusts. So I want you to stay in an isometric hold. Feel free to play with your balance if you like. Here in this place where I stand steady, and now release. Nice work. One weight or two comes up and over, overhead presses. Is using one weight over your head fine? Yes. Would it be a good idea to drop to the floor and rest there and do those nice extensions? Well, if your shoulders need a little TLC, a little protection and care, of course. It's our last eight. Remember that it's not important if we can do every single one. Sometimes if we can't, that means that we have actually chosen the right amount of weight because we're challenging ourselves. Let's pull those weights down, set this down. Come down to the floor, so spread your mat out if you haven't already done so. We really don't have much time left. We're going to come into a plank, whether you're on your forearms or whether you're on your legs or on your hands or on your legs, either way. It's up to you. So let's anchor strongly through that core. Look out, bringing ourselves to the knees if that is a better experience, more effective. We do what is going to get us the best result. So we're going to reach two, four times on one side, four times on the other. It's a countdown. Three times on the first side. Three, two, one, hold. Three times on the other side. Three, two, one, hold. Here we go. Two, two. Here's our singles. Eight, seven, six. Five more. Four, three, two, and one. Sit back, stretching forward. So if you are able, as you come up and come into a standing position, we're gonna take a very quick stretch. To join me at 10 o'clock, we are going to have more concentrated core work. Bar fusion will be transitioning into core fusion. So we're gonna start opening up our options. Always bringing in elements of the things we love, bar and yoga and Pilates, and then some strength as well. Let's take a quick quad stretch, reaching that hand out. Come to the other side. If you need a little more stretching, whoa, I'm tipping over today. Take your quad stretch. Then stand tall. Some days are better than others. Balance is, to me, balance is like a river. It flows one side to the other. It takes a lot of concentration. And it changes daily. Let's take a deep breath all the way in. Hands come over our heads. There's your tricep stretch. Releasing. Let's release the upper trapezius. And come to the other side. Nice and easy, another deep breath in. As we roll down, I'd like to thank you always for joining us here at the virtual. I told my class last night how much we enjoy being here for you, and we truly do. So we appreciate your time. We appreciate your commitment. See you again next time, everyone. Have a great day. Thank you very much.